A big question many homeowners are contemplating right now is, does my current home deliver the space I need to continue working from home? And so if the answer is no, I'm here to help you figure out what is next. So we all know a lot has changed over the past year and a half. For many people, the rise in remote work influenced what they're actually looking for in a home, and it created an appetite for a dedicated home office space. Some homeowners took advantage of this situation, and they actually went ahead and purchased a bigger home. Others actually thought, though, that working from home would be temporary, so they chose to stay put and get creative with the space they already had, and they made it work for themselves. But recent headlines indicate that working from home really isn't just a passing fad. So if you're a homeowner still longing for a dedicated home office or homeschool space, now may be the time to find the home that addresses your evolving needs. More and more companies are delaying their plans to return to the office, while others are actually deciding to remain fully remote permanently. The number of remote workers over the next 5 years is actually expected to nearly double what it was before the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic. In fact, by the year 2025, it is estimated that more than 36 million Americans will work remotely. And that's an increase from just over 16 million Americans that are the pre-pandemic rates. So, how do these numbers really impact you as a homeowner? So if you own your home, it's important you realize that the continued remote work opportunities that you didn't think existed before, they may exist now. Since you don't have to be tied to a specific area for your work anymore, you have more options and more flexibility on where you can live. If you're one of the nearly 23% of workers who will absolutely remain 100% remote, you have the option to move to even a lower cost area of living, or maybe even a location of your dreams. If you search for a home in a more affordable area, you'll be able to get more home for the money, maybe freeing up more opportunity for options in that home or some of the amenities that you would otherwise want in a home but otherwise couldn't afford. Or if you want, you can move to an area of your dream, somewhere you've always wanted to live, maybe somewhere near a beach or near the mountains or in a community that has the amenities that you've always been looking for. Without your job tying you to a specific location, you now have the opportunity to find your ideal spot. So quick note, can't resist. I'm actually in Orlando, Florida. We're known for our amazing weather, our endless entertainment options, and we also happen to be situated between two amazing coasts with white sand beaches. Just saying, let me know if I can help. Now, if you're one of the almost 15% of individuals who will have a partially remote or hybrid schedule, relocating within your existing local area to a home that's maybe further away from your office could be a great choice too. Since you won't be going to work every day, a slightly longer commute to a more suburban or rural neighborhood may be a worthwhile trade-off with a home for a home with more options and maybe some more of those comforts that you're looking for. This is definitely something to think about. In fact, I would say more than that. It's something to ask about. So the bottom line, if ongoing remote work is changing what you need in your home, let's connect to find the home that truly delivers on what your new wish list will look like.